I'm Betty, and today we're going to make miniature gardens, also known as fairy gardens. And one thing I like to think about as far as this kind of gardening goes is that you're making a little miniature landscape. And so it's kind of a study for, like, if you ever did want to re-landscape your yard, you could start with just like a, you know, diorama like this. Or the other good thing about this kind of gardening is if you don't feel like landscaping a whole giant property, you can make this tiny little landscape and just be done and enjoy that, you know? Like, why work harder? So you have a pot with a hole in it, and the first thing you do is cover it up with a couple little stones. And what the stones will do is allow the water to percolate through when you water it, but not let the soil run out the bottom of the pot onto your patio. I usually just grab these rough ones and save the decorative ones for the gardening, so you guys can use those if you want. But I'm just going to do this demo really quick, and then I'll help you make yours.
Oh, great.
Okay. So the first thing you do is grab this good quality potting soil, and I'll hold my rocks in place. I'm going to put the first scoop on so they don't jog away from the hole. And it takes a few scoops because the main number one technique about this miniature landscaping is that you're going to really provide a firm foundation for all of these different decorations. And hey, yay!
Hey,
four people.
My mom and my daughter. Yeah.
Okay. Do you guys mind if I start off?
If you guys want to start.
So this is the number one technique of miniature gardening. Hi, you guys.
Hi.
Welcome to our class.
Thank you.
I'm Betty. Thanks for coming.
Thanks. We've been looking forward to it. She just didn't come out of town, too.
Hi, nice to see you guys.
Thank you.
Don't worry about being late.
Okay.
We're totally chill.
Okay.
Thank you. So I just started the demo, so you didn't miss hardly anything. And I'm going to go over it again. So fill your container with good quality, well-draining potting soil. We use the good draining stuff because we use mostly succulents. Whoa, for these kind of, those aren't usually there. For these kind of gardens, we plant mostly succulents. So they need really good drainage in the pot. And the number one technique for making a fairy garden, a miniature landscape, is to really give it a firm foundation. So when you put your potting soil in the container, you're gonna smoosh it down really nice and firm. And then you're gonna think about, well, what do I want my landscape to have? Do I want it to have just a flat surface? Do I want there to be any little hills and dales? Do I wanna create some kind of a retaining wall with like a little border garden behind that? Do I want a little river or a stream or water feature of some kind? You could have a pond, you could make a little lake with a dock and a boat. We have all sorts of stuff in there to make any kind of world that you can imagine. One thing I always like to have in my landscape is some kind of a tree. So I always pick at least one of my plants to be kind of taller. There's a little bug in there. Get out of my garden, please. And so I always plant the tree kind of in the back of the landscape to provide shade and beauty. Just be a smooth flat surface, and I do need a teeny bit more soil because once I smoosh it down, it started sinking lower and lower. And you'll find that as you water and as your garden lives in your, you know, in your patio or wherever you keep it, they do tend to go down and down and down. And so after about a year, you kind of want to refurbish it and replant. So if you start at the correct surface level, it'll stay that way for longer. So now I'm going to make a little hardscape with these miniature flagstones.
I know you'll probably need that.
And I do always thank you. You're so smart. So this will be the foundation for my little house. So first I'm going to put down sand, which gives a little bit of a break between the dark color of the potting soil and what we are creating as our miniature fairy world landscape. So I always try and find, when I'm using a material like this and I have a curved edge, I try and find the curved kind of edge of whatever material I'm using. It looks like on this one it's that guy. And then it kind of, see how it kind of fits in there a little bit better? Like puzzle pieces. And then you can piece in another one. And again, you want to firm them down nice and tight. And puzzle it all together. And it looks like that's big enough for this cute little house. So I'm gonna leave it like that. And this is the first level of what you're doing. So first you wanna do soil, and then all your hardscape elements, which are pebbles, rocks and streams, a great lawn, which will be so fun to have in this garden. It's very zen and relaxing. So again, I'm trying to kind of find the curve of this material and match it to the curve of my pot. And then you just gently kind of tear away the pieces that don't fit and tuck in the edges. And so now do you see how the lawn is flush with the surface of my flagstone foundation for my house that I created? And then now I'm gonna put some tiny pebbles in. Can you hand me those beigey ones to go with the flagstone? Yeah, there we go. So these are gonna, they're small enough that they're gonna sink into the little cracks in between. So we get a nice smooth surface that's like multi-textured. Okay, so see how those fall right into place. This, and you can keep like tweaking your edges. If you have pieces that stick up like that, you kind of just, you're kind of like a sculptor. Like you're sculpting a world with all these different elements and creating a like living sculpture that's multi-textured and has many pretty colors. So now before I get too far with the hardscape, I'm going to plant the rest of my garden items. So I'm going to use this gorgeous purple thing, which is called the gorgeous purple thing. It is called Anaxerxos. I'm totally pronouncing that wrong.
Those are actually new too.
This is new. We haven't used this one before.
George just got this.
Do you know how to pronounce it, Ruth?
I think it's called Anaxerxos.
Anaxerxos.
Anaxerxos, something like
that. Thank you. Thank you. I'm fired. Oops. So one thing I do, if I have a very shallow container, this isn't too shallow. I like how nice and deepy this one is. And so this plant will fit in here nicely. But if you have a shallow container, like these two, your plant is way too tall. So the technique there is to kind of zhuzh the roots a little. You want to do it kind of gently. Don't worry, I'll clean up your pot. And you want to kind of just shorten the root ball. You have to do it gently. It's kind of like surgery. I'm not a doctor. You can, I don't want to, you could, certain plants you can break apart. Yeah, you could break these apart. So I think that's short enough that if you had a little mound, you could, you know, get it in there. Mm-hmm. So I'll come back and fix that for it. So this will add a nice pop of color over here in my little relaxing zen garden. And then over here, I'm going to use this one as a kind of ground covering plant. And I think I will pop this one apart so it kind of forms a hedge over here. Because hedges give you privacy, something pretty to look at. So there's my pretty hedge. And you kind of want to straighten them up, grab some soil from over here, tuck it in over here gently. Does that look like a hedge?
Yeah.
I think it's not too bad. Okay, so kind of jiggle everything to get the dirt off. And then of course I made my lawn dirty so I can just clean that up. I'm going to smooth this out because it seems like it's sinking as it goes over to the edge. So I'm going to build up this edge a tiny bit. Okay, look at that. I'm coming along. And then you clean up all the edges as you go. So now we have our edge. Don't be afraid to firm them in. Like I always, when I firm the plants in, I kind of push down around the outside of the roots, but not right on the plant. Do you see how I'm kind of doing that? And they're standing up a little taller and sturdier. Because then when you move it, they don't jiggle apart. See that? And you have to move it to your car. When you get home, you got to move it out of the car to the patio. So you don't want all these elements to pop apart. Firm this guy up. Okay. So now, you're getting allergic. Now, I think I want to add a little more of a hardscape element over here. So I think I'm going to add a little more sand to color the dark part of the soil. So it's not all dirty looking. Okay, and then a few more of these pretty beige petals. All right, and so I'll tweak that after because I know you guys want to get started on your gardens. And now we can put all of our beautiful accoutrements. We have a beautiful gypsy tent. A nice relaxing little lounge chair because fairies work hard and they need to take breaks. And on our great lawn, we have a cute flamingo. Over by our hedge, we have a pretty little gazing ball. Isn't that cute? Tuck that in. A little picnic basket because fairies get very hungry. Christmas lights, because why the heck not? And oh, and this is in case when the fairy's done resting, she wants to work on her garden, she can. She's got some garden tools. These packages, I tell you, they're hard to get everything out of. Okay, so where should these go? Maybe just like picking up over here. Or we could lean them against the house. That's cute. That kind of looks real. What else do I have? That's it. Okay. What do you think of our little relaxing fairy garden? Do you like it?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So then I would just kind of tweak this over here and fix it a little, maybe add a couple little boulders, which are the, yeah, that rock package. Boulders add a lot to a landscape. Even miniature landscapes need boulders. That looks pretty. And then maybe just a couple more. All right. So I know I mentioned water features and I didn't cover that, but if anybody does want to make a water feature, we can, I can help you do that. Like any kind of little river thing, as with the sand and the rocks, only you're creating a shape of natural stream and putting down blue sand and blue sparkle rocks, and it works out really cute. So y'all want to get started? Okay. So you can pick out the class B includes a pot like in that size, and I think the class B is 15, and that includes a pot that size and the soil, hardscape elements, rocks. It doesn't include all the little treasures and trinkets and plants. Those are separate.
And can we do one in one?
You guys can make as many gardens as you want, and I'll stay here and help you do it. And no rush, you can take your time. And I'll be here till you're done.
Thank you. Where did you?
I had this in the stones, the boulders.
So that the river goes that way?
Okay.
And you want the grass to go all the way to this edge?
I think that looks nice.
You can do it.
And so let's kind of shove it over a little, and now we're going to
maybe accentuate your hill a little bit more.
I like this. Valley here. This is kind of like how they built Central Park in New York City. Put in a lot of hills and dales there.
We almost could have another.
Right, look at that. This is good times. Now, we've never done this in this class before. You know that? You're an innovator.
I just thought of a hill, so I'm like, what else?
It's such a good idea. Thank you. You're like, I don't want that hillside all over my car.
For the bird. How's the bird house?
Popsicle sticked.
Okay, so if I'm doing layout, do I want
anything under it?
So
there's
some stone under it?
Oh,
you choose three
plants? Right, now you have to put more ground on top. Your fungus. It's so nice.
Yeah.
So it's vivid.
I love that pot. That is so
yummy. It's pressed in a valley size more.
Yeah. Coffee helps with that.
Oh, good, Tibby. You're doing a little mound too. A littler mound.
We're doing like a. I want to do like a valley, like two mounds here, and then like grass.
Now come around.
Okay. Take a look. Are you going to use the moss as well for your little hill?
The moss.
The moss.
They all but hug you when you arrive.
Really?
Yeah. And drop off and pick up syrup if you need to. Never a line, there's never chaos.
It's like the Erie Airport, except not as nice.
Anchoring everything, you know, so that it doesn't pop apart.
isn't too much pieced together in some areas. Or
no,
whatever.
But you know what? I think we can also use this guy to hold the moss in place too.
Like I said, if I had tried to do this all by myself, I would have been overwhelmed. Like,
what am I doing?
Yeah, overwhelmed and like at the, you know, craft store or whatever, just feeling like, yeah,
it's
like
so fun having you guys here.
This is great. This is so much fun.
You guys are really good at it.
We have the best teacher in town.
Thank you. I'll take it.
Yeah.
So then maybe another thing that helps hold stuff in place is like a little molder here and there.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
It kind of just anchors it. So we have big white ones. We have.
I keep on grabbing some this, and then not doing anything, but I kind of want the bigger ones.
This one has some good medium-sized ones.
Okay.
But then over on the ground over there, there's giant ones that are like weathered like that, and they don't usually mind if I steal them. So far, I haven't gotten yelled at. So.
Is there a tiny
piece of moss around that you're thinking about putting? Yeah, there's tons of plants.